Chapter 28. Against the King of Tyre. The word of Yahweh was addressed to me as follows. Son of man, say to the King of Tyre, the Lord Yahweh says this. Because your heart has grown proud, you thought, I am a god. I am divinely earth enthroned, far out to sea. Though you are human, not divine, you have allowed yourself to think like God. So, are you wiser than Daniel? No sage as wise as you. By your wisdom and your intelligence, you have made yourself a fortune. You have put gold and silver into your treasuries. Such is your skill in trading. Your fortune has continued to increase. And your fortune has made your heart grow prouder. And so, the Lord Yahweh says this. Since you have allowed yourself to think like God, very well, I'm going to bring foreigners against you, the most barbarous of the nations. They will draw a sword against you, against your fine wisdom. They will desecrate your splendor. They will throw you down into the grave, and you will die in a violent death, far out to sea. Will you still think I'm God when your slaughterers confront you? But you will be human, not divine, in the clutches of the ones who strike you down. You will die like uncircumcised out at the hand of foreigners. For I have spoken, declares the Lord Yahweh. The fall of the King of Tyre. The word of Yahweh was addressed to me as follows. Son of man, raise a lament for the King of Tyre. Say to him, the Lord Yahweh says this. You used to be a model of perfection, full of wisdom, perfect in beauty. You were in Eden, the garden of God. All kinds of gem formed your mantle. Sard, topaz, diamond, chrysolite, onyx, jasper, sapphire, garnet, emerald, and your ear pendants and spangles were made of gold. All was ready on the day you were created. I made you a living creature with outstretched wings as guardian. You were on the holy mountain of God. You walked amid red-hot coals. Your behavior was exemplary from the day you were created, until guilt was found in you. Because your busy trading has filled you with violence and sin, I have thrown you down from the mountains of God and destroyed you, guardian-winged creature, amid the coals. Your heart has grown proud because of your beauty. Your wisdom was corrupted by your splendor. I have thrown you to the ground. I have made you a spectacle for kings. By the immense number of your crimes, by the dishonesty of your trading, you have defiled your sanctuary. So I have brought fire out of you to devour you. I have reduced you to ashes on the ground before the eyes of all who saw you. All of the nations, all who know you, are stunned at your fate. You are an object of terror, gone forever. Against Sidon. The word of Yahweh was addressed to me as follows. Son of man, turn towards Sidon, and prophesy against her. Say, the Lord of Yahweh says this. I am against you, Sidon. I will show you my glory in you. They will know I am Yahweh once I execute sentence on her and display my holiness in her, for I shall send her the plague and there will be blood in her streets. And in her the deal will fall under the sword raised against her from all sides, and they will know that I am Yahweh. Israel delivered from the nations. No more for the house of Israel shall any of the hostile nations surrounding there than be a thorn that wounds or a briar that tears. And they will know that I am Yahweh. The Lord Yahweh says this. When I gather the house of Israel back from the peoples where they are despaired, I shall display my glory in them for the nations to see. They will live on the soil which I give to my servant Jacob. They will live there in confidence, build houses, plant vineyards. They will live in safety, once I inflict punishments on all the hostile nations surrounding them, and they will know that I am Yahweh, their God.